Classify the quadrilateral whose vertices are A, negative 2, 3, B, 3, 3, C, 3, negative 2, and D, negative 2, negative 2. So let's plot the points. A is negative 2, 3, which is right there. B is at 3, 3. C is at 3, negative 2. And then D is at negative 2, negative 2. Now I'll connect the vertices and see what we have. Okay, so it looks like a special quadrilateral of some kind. Could be a parallelogram, could be a square, could be a rectangle or rhombus. Let's go ahead and figure it out. Now I'm going to first find the measures, and it looks like all the sides are either horizontal or vertical, so I can just count along the grid. No need to use the Pythagorean theorem here. So AB is 5, BC is 5, DC is 5, and AD is 5. Okay, so we have a rhombus. And the reason why is AB equals BC equals CD equals DA, which also equals 5. Okay. So all that's left is to determine whether or not it's also a rectangle, which would make it a square. Because remember, if you have properties of a rhombus and a rectangle together, you have a square. So really what we need to figure out is whether the diagonals are congruent. That's what will make it a square. So I'm going to draw the diagonals. Okay, and then we're going to use the Pythagorean theorem to figure out the length of each diagonal. So the right triangle is DCB for this first one. And to go from D to B, you go right 5 and up 5. So DB squared is 5 squared plus 5 squared, which is 25 plus 25. Which is 50. So DB squared is 50. Take the square root of both sides, DB equals square root 50. Okay, now let's look at diagonal AC. To go from A to C, you go down 5 and then right 5. So the right triangle has legs of 5 and 5, and AC is the hypotenuse. So AC squared equals 5 squared plus 5 squared, which is 25 plus 25, which is 50, which is AC squared. So AC equals the square root of 50. Now both diagonals have the same measure, which means they're congruent. So I'm going to say that DB equals AC, or I could also say congruent if I wanted to. They really say the same thing in different ways. Having the same measure, you can conclude there's congruence. And I guess I could do the same up here. Can make all these congruent as well. Okay, so that means we have a rectangle. So since we have a rhombus and rectangle combined, we can say that ABCD is a square. And the reasoning for that is that we have a rhombus because all four sides are congruent, and also the diagonals are congruent, which makes it a rectangle, and rhombus and rectangle combined makes a square.